we are on Sakurajima, an active volcano in Japan. Rock, which is melted, rushes out of the volcano, and we call that lava. So when that molten liquid rock is inside the surface of the earth, that is when it hasn't come out yet, we give it a different name. We call it magma. Our first and very special kind of rock, called igneous rock, is going to be formed over here. And it's actually pretty interesting how they are formed. During Earth's early formation, billions of years ago, the planet underwent a period that allowed the heaviest elements to sink to the center and the lighter ones to rise to the surface. The planet, as a result, has four layers: the outermost crust, followed by the mantle, and then the core, which is again divided into the outer core and the inner core. So rocks in the mantle and the core are still really hot from the formation of the Earth about 4.6 billion years ago. When the Earth formed, material collided at high speeds. These collisions created heat. That heat became trapped in the Earth. This and many other things caused enough heat to partially melt some rocks in the upper mantle. The magma is formed from rocks and minerals melting because of these super high temperatures, and eventually the lava creeps out from these very ruptures. When the lava comes out, it's really hot. In fact, it can even reach temperatures of 1200 degrees Celsius. When it comes out, however, notice that the temperature of the atmosphere is going to be lower than the lava. So what starts happening? The molten rocks start to cool down. In some time, they soon start solidifying, and slowly they're going to form hard rocks like this. It's how a candle starts melting on burning. And then slowly, as the drops reach below, away from the flame, they're going to solidify to form vats again. When the lava cools on the Earth's surface, it forms what is called basalt. I'm actually standing on basalt, and if you check basalt, you'll see that it has very fine grains and it's dark in color. Now, suppose magma cools just below the Earth's surface, it forms granite. And if you've heard about granite, you'll know that it comes in so many different colors. Granite has three main minerals. The first is something called feldspar, that is pink in color. Then there is something called quartz, which is gray in color, which we use to make watches with. The final one is shiny black mica. So the color of the granite rocks depends on how much feldspar is there in it. The more it has, the more pink would be the color. So if you look at these three different granite slabs around me, they're all looking so different because the amount of feldspar in them is very different. Granite is used widely by us. It's used to make statues, buildings, and so many different things. So we spoke about feldspar, we spoke about quartz. I'm also going to talk to you about something called pumice. And pumice is a rock that is formed outside, when the lava that cools outside the Earth's crust has some gases mixed in it. So what happens is that the rock becomes a solid with the gases. The gases are later going to escape, and wherever they used to be, there are holes in the spaces behind. If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.